I am Dr. Chandrabhanu Parija. I am working as cardiac surgeon. My specialty is cardiothoracic and vascular surgery. I am working in BR Life, Kalinga Super Speciality Hospital, Bhubaneswar. So I will be talking about how lifestyle diseases affect our heart. In that, I would like to highlight like what are the major risk factors for getting a heart attack. Basically, there are 5 or 6 major risk factors that cause heart attack, and out of them, some of them are called major risk factors. That is like family history. If one of your parent is having any heart attack or heart related diseases before the age of 60, and anybody in the family having high lipid or cholesterol level, if you are a smoker, if you are leading a sedentary lifestyle, or if you are having diabetes or hypertension, or you are not having enough exercise. So to avoid all this can lead to deposition of cholesterol or what we call is plaque in the arteries of the heart, which can block the artery, and then you can get chest pain, and later on when it becomes critical, then you may get a heart attack. So to prevent all this, we have to lead a healthy lifestyle. What does it mean? It doesn't mean running to the gym every day. The best exercise for the heart is to do brisk walk for 30 minutes a day, 5 days a week. That will be enough for your heart. But if you want to do more than that, it's not going to do any harm. But minimum of this we should do. And the lifestyle, especially the IT people, that they are doing like 5 days a week and then 2 days of binge drinking and eating out, those things are to be avoided. Basically, we should avoid so-called fast foods, heavily salted foods and canned foods. Better is to consume more fruits, salads and less of oil. This can reduce all the things, all the risk factors that causes heart attack, and along with that, little bit of exercise will help your heart. So how to know a person has got a heart attack? So basically there is, for layman, it's difficult to know whether it is a heart attack or a gastric pain or pain related to the stomach. Many a times it is even being confused by like periphery doctors working in periphery also. They keep treating patients as gastric, but ultimately it turns out to be heart attack. So everybody should know what are the symptoms which can mimic a chest pain and which can lead to a heart attack. So we have to know that whenever we get a chest pain related to any kind of activity, any stress, or after having a very heavy meal, then we should be suspicious that it may be pain related to the chest and it can lead to a heart attack, and then we should seek doctor's attention. So it's not only chest pain. Sometimes we may feel uncomfortable without any reason, sweating profusely, or maybe having respiratory distress. Many a times, most of the patients, like 30% of patients having heart attack are usually diabetes or having elevated blood sugar. So those patients, usually due to their nerve involvement, they may not be having pain, but they will have chest like respiratory distress or some uncomfortable or not very good feeling. So that can also be a symptom of heart attack. So whenever we come across somebody complaining of chest pain or chest discomfort, we have to suspect that it can be a heart attack. Heart attack usually is more dangerous than pain that originates from the stomach. So if we feel that I myself is having chest pain, or somebody else noticing somebody else having chest pain, we should encourage them to seek doctor's attention, because the diagnosis at the right time can save a life.